go now to Caracas to speak with Carol Delgado, the Venezuelan consul general in New York. She's returned to her home city to pay her respects to President Chavez and attend the funeral. Carol Delgado, welcome to Democracy Now! Can you describe what's happening in the streets of Caracas right now?
Yeah, thanks for having me, Enya. Thanks for the wonderful, the outstanding job that you are doing by telling the truth to the Americans. What is happening here in Caracas is that there is like a mix between a huge international summit with 50 heads of state from all over the world coming improvised.
Carol, if you could speak as loud as you possibly can, because it's a little difficult to hear you. If you could speak as loud as you can, there's a loud generator sound in the background.
Yeah, Amy, here in Venezuela, over 2 million people have gone to the streets with all their love. I think it's important to highlight that for Venezuelans, this is not the death of the president. This is the death of a family person, of a father. And that's what Venezuelans feel. And they have gone to the streets to accompany, to say the last goodbye to President Chavez. But something outstanding that I got to see yesterday night is that there was a long line of over 30,000 people waiting to give the last word to a coffin where President Chavez is. And you could see, you know, his face, and also the coffin has a Venezuelan flag. And it is it's a very touching thing. People are going there. They are giving President Chavez the honors. But it's very important to highlight that this is like a sort of popular mass, where the people feel that they are gonna go to mourn a father, go to mourn a teacher, basically as somebody who is very important to them. And also you see that the people, most of the people who are there, are the disenfranchised, the poor people of Venezuela, and that feel that they have come to existence after Chavez came into the Venezuelan society in 1992, after the coup.
Did you know him personally?
It's like Chavez. Yeah. I had the privilege of knowing him personally. Yeah. I had an opportunity to talk to him about the popular power. And as you know, President Chavez has been fostering a new way of democracy, the participatory democracy, giving directly a participatory budget so that people can cope with the problems they have in their communities. And in the month of International Women's Day, I think it's important to highlight that 60% of women are the ones leading this participatory democracy in Venezuela.
Carol Delgado, I was wondering your response to the criticism. I wanted to play a clip for you from Michael Schifter. We spoke to him on Wednesday. He's president of the Inter-American Dialogue in Washington, D.C. He criticized Chavez on a number of issues, including his handling of Venezuelans' economy. Listen to what Michael Schifter says and then respond.
He really had an opportunity to reshape in a significant way and put the country on a sustainable path of development. I'm not sure that if one looks at Venezuela today that it's on that path. And I think you have enormous problems that are there. There are shortages of basic goods. There is the highest inflation rate in Latin America. Crime is off the charts. If you look at the crime rate when he came in versus the crime rate today, there's this tremendous insecurity. Caracas is one of the most crime-ridden cities in the world today. So this is not a government that I think has been very competent and very effective.
Your response to Michael Schifter, Carol Delgado, Consul General of Venezuela in New York, though today in her home city of Caracas for the funeral.
For Americans, it's very difficult to understand what's happening here, because They don't understand what culture is going on here. When we talk about violence, I think it's important to highlight that there are systemic reasons why the violence is a problem in Venezuela. And poverty took a very important toll on Venezuela. And many of the people who are now criminals were kids that didn't have to eat, that were fed with bottles, with water, and the powder and sugar. So that's not happening. Venezuela has reduced poverty dramatically, particularly extreme poverty. Venezuelans right now have education free up to the university level. We have free universal health for everyone. And those kind of achievements are fantastic. I think it's very difficult for Michael Shifter and for many Americans to understand Venezuelans, because they don't understand about the religiosity, about the connection that President Chavez has been able to engage with the people of Venezuela. And I think this is a process that will continue building socialism. We don't have all the answers. There are many things to be done and done better. But we're on a path. We didn't have a plan to develop the country. Now we do. So I think President Chavez has left this process with a path, We're working on industrialization of the country. We're working on food sovereignty. And those are achievements that are undeniable.